Okay, and here we have what is this device to which we are going to be able to recover it. In this video tutorial we are not going to use the PC. We are going to use a method completely without a PC, EH. It is very easy and it is very simple, recommendation to watch the video tutorial step by step. If you do not want to miss any of these details, what are we going to do? Well, we have to be connected to a Wi-Fi network to be able to do this same process. Let's go, EH, let's connect to the Wi-Fi networks. We're going to give you the tour so that you can see that it is completely blocked, that it has a screen lock, also finally it has the forgotten Gmail account. What are we going to do to be able to recover this device? Well, to be able to do it, as you can see here is what this lock pin is that we have forgotten and we don't remember it, and also finally it has what is the Google account. The forgotten Gmail account, how are we going to be able to recover our device? Well, we are going to use a SIM card with a PIN code, EH. But we are going to use a different method than the previous ones. We are not going to go into settings in order to recover our device. We do not need to be able to go into settings. Without having to go into settings. So what we're going to do is enter what the block salt is. With that PIN code we are blocked, we click here on emergency call. We're going to dial any emergency number. Depending on your country, we dial it, we click on call. It will load here what it is a location, we're going to select it. And we're going to enter, here. These phones always, hold it, ready. We have not entered emergency call, we're going to try again. We try, dial the second. We'll see to realize that we enter, there we enter, now yes. We enter, withdraw. Ready, we click here where it says skip. We click on skip here we would get any of these options. We're going to select any of these. Let's see. Now what are we going to do? Well, we're going to enter here where it says call. Here in call. We're going to click here where it says send a message. We click where it says send a message. Now here we're going to write www. YouTube, YouTube. YouTube.com, we click on it, now we click here on load. Now we click on YouTube here we are going to enable a function. We click here on allow, we click on the little ball that appears here. We click on settings, we click on accessibility, we enable this accessibility option. We click here on control and then we click on it here are the blue letters. We are going to click here in settings here we are going to enable what this accessibility menu is. We enable it, the accessibility menu is now enabled. Now what are we going to do, well being here with this. Visibility menu we are going to click on the magnifying glass that appears here once we are. Here we are going to write. Battery usage we are going to write but we are going to select the one that says app. Now that is the one we are going to select we are going to Increase battery. We are going to write battery and we are going to AR as you can see to appear. In this one Google appears, but it is going to give us the option to disable it. So we are not going to select this, we are going to select the one that says app. We select this one that says app. Then we click here where it says battery usage of the applications. Then what are we going to do this? Let's search for Google services here if it lets us enable it. As you can see, it let us enable it. Now, what are we going to do? Let's restart our device and we'll wait a few seconds until it fully boots up so we can then give it the following settings and be able to recover our device in a very easy way. But this doesn't end there yet, because at the end of the video I'm going to explain how to correct the errors, because our device stays, we get stuck, we get so slow, we get stuck, the screen won't work correctly. So I'm going to explain the step of being able to do that process and be able to recover it, and that you don't have any inconvenience. We're going to wait a few seconds until it restarts. When it starts, what we're going to do is the following. We're going to wait for it to load. We're going to click accept here. We're going to click accept here. The easiest part comes. We're going to wait until it gives us an option here that appears wait a moment looking for updates. When this option appears, and we're going to do the next one to be able to enable Google services again now. Then we wait, we're going to wait until we get here to skip. We're going to get the option to skip. Well, we're going to click here where it says do not copy. We click here in do not copy, and here we would get this option that we were telling you for a moment looking for updates. What are we going to do now here? We go back and we are going to leave it here. Now we click on the three dots, we click here where it says accessibility. Here we are going to write again the same option battery, we are going to write it there. Now we click here where it says app, then we click app. Battery usage, we look for Google services here and we are going to enable it. That easy, we have already enabled it. Now what are we going to do? Let's go back gently, we are going to click here on continue and skip. Now here we are already in Google services, but as we were telling you, are we click on skip, our device is blocked. I am going to tell you how our device is left and how we are going to be able to recover it. Well, here we have already recovered it, but this is what I want to tell you is this. I turn off the screen, I turn on the screen and it stays, only if we go down and it works. Then what is it? We go here in system, we go in system. We click here on reset. We click here on delete everything, and when our device is restored, it would completely free us from any error. And when they restart, we only have to do the same process. Configure the normal, we are not going to do anything else, we add the account, the screen lock, and that would be all.